Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. In this video, I am going to be going over what makes a tournament format, and like how to understand it, and like how to basically break it down. This is going to be a pretty unedited video, so if you guys don't like those types of videos, still watch it because I think it will help you. But if you really don't like these types of videos, then you can feel free to click off here. But it's really going to be helpful if you guys want to make earnings this season, if you guys want to succeed in tournaments. It's how to understand a tournament's format, okay? And before this video quickly starts, I would like to let all of you guys know I have made a Twitch. Please go check that out. I stream there every single Saturday and Sunday. I don't know what times yet, but I will let you guys know shortly. But please go follow my Twitch, go do all that stuff. Check out my Twitch. There's a link in the description, so be sure to check that out. Okay. So as you guys can probably tell, I'm a little bit sick, but you know, that's fine, whatever. So I'm basically just going to be showing you guys an example of the DreamHack Online Open Heats, which start on November 12th. This is a duos tournament. So I guess that's the first aspect of understanding a tournament's format. Please understand what game, like obviously understand what game mode it is and how many rounds there are. So as an example, in this DreamHack, there is, I believe, four rounds. So there's the Heat 1, which starts at 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. on, I think like 3 days from now, which is Thursday, I believe. I don't know though. Thursday. And then we've got, this one starts, same day, but it starts at 9 p.m. and ends at 12 a.m. So this is Heat 2. So it's Heat 1, Heat 2. Then we've got semifinals, which start on November 13th. They start earlier in the day around, 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. on November 13th. And then DreamHack finals are from 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. This is a big tournament. And then you should also understand the prize pooling, which is basically $15,000 for first place, and top 50 gets $400, which is a pretty good prize pool. I think DreamHack's doing a great job of setting up these tournaments, and it's the first duos tournament we've had since the Duo Cash Cups back in Chapter 2, Season 2. So yes, basically the most important part about, I guess, this specific tournament is going to just generally be understanding what the point format is, I guess. So we've got the point format up right here, and as you guys can see, it is 6 points for Victory Royale, and then top two, top three, top four, top five are plus 3 points, and then top six all the way through top, I believe, 21 is plus 2 points. So this is a very high scoring, like, I guess, tournament. And right here, I'm pretty sure the max amount of points you can get each game. So there's a 20 elimination cap. So that is 100 points for eliminations. And then, let me just do some quick math. So, plus two. Okay, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 times 2, that is 30. So that's 30 points from these. And then there's 1, 2, 3. Then, okay, so that's plus 3. So that's 33. Yeah, so, 133 we're at right now, and then 136, 139, and then 142. So the max amount of points you can get from each game is 132 points. I mean, sorry, 142 points. Unless I'm doing my math, like, extremely, extremely wrong, but I don't think I am. But, like I was saying, I completely forgot to include these ones. So, no, there is, 32, 35, and 151 points, I believe, unless I'm doing my math wrong. Let me know if I am. Anyway, so that's the amount of points that you can get, and you should also understand who you're playing against, and I guess how they're going to be playing. So in the opens of the tournament, you're going to be playing against other opens players, which are people who aren't as experienced and competitive, who are just getting into competitive and not as good as, like, let's say a professional player, or even a semi-professional player. So you should try to go in with the mindset. Some of your games you're going to push a little bit more depending on how your lobby looks, and some of your games you're going to play for placement more, also depending on how your lobby looks. Your lobby is really important to pay attention to, simply because it's basically how you base, I guess, what you're going to be doing in the tournament, like that you base it off of that. So moving on to the semifinals, the format stays the same all throughout the tournament, like the format of, like, the point format and all that stuff stays the same. But from heats, which is, I guess, these heats right here, the top 250 teams will qualify from each heat. So we've got 250 teams, which is 500 players, and 250 teams, which is also 500 players. So that makes 1,000 players going into the semifinals, all right? From the semifinals, the top 50 teams, which is very, very a big jump from 1,000 from 500 teams to 50 teams, will qualify up to the finals, which is the big prize pool thing. And this is just a big prize pool. They give away all this money, and I guess, you know, it's just pretty basic. But in the finals, there's, I guess, just, you know, they're going to be casting it. They're going to be casting the semifinals as well, but they're really just going to be paying attention to pro players. So don't worry about casting too much until you, unless you get to the finals. And if you do get to the finals, very good job. It is difficult to get to a DreamHack finals, but yeah. So I guess that's just the general basis of how to understand your point format and all that stuff. But now I'm going to be going into something on how to understand the format of, I guess, what the lobbies will look like, all right? So obviously you guys know that it's a pretty high scoring tournament. We've got 5 points for elims and a crap ton of placement. So obviously placement points each game, if you win the game, is about, 51 points. So that seems pretty good. So I'm betting in most of these games, unless you're playing in a very dead lobby, which is where people just want to quickly get this game over with in W key so that they won't have to W key in the future. Unless you're playing in that, most people are going to be playing for placements. Placement is arguably the best way to play in DreamHack because kills are also worth a lot. If you get 10 kills, that's 50 points. That's a lot of points. And if you get like 50 points per game, that's 500. That's extremely good, you know? So there's many different ways of trying to, I guess, succeed in the tournament. But I'd say the best way is really just understand who's going to be doing what in these games. Like if there's going to be people W keying, play a little bit safer. If there's going to be, I guess, nobody W keying, then land at like a bigger POI and then just leave, you know, like, and you need to have your landing spot ready. You need to have your like loot route ready, your ideal loadout ready. All of those videos I've made before, so be sure to check them out on my channel. You guys can just scroll through or look at my playlist section, which is something I forgot to mention. I do have a playlist section with all my videos like organized into organized tabs, which is like solo videos, drop spot videos, VOD reviews, like all that stuff. So you guys can check that out as well. But I guess the general basis of this video was to summarize how to understand properly a tournament's format. And I'd say the most important thing, other than all of what I just said, is really just practicing what's going to be important. So if it's a W key tournament and you want to be able to be good at W keying, first things first, watch my video on W keying. I'm going to link it in the top right corner right now. But also, be sure to, you know, just work on your mechanics, work on your piece control, work on all of that stuff that helps you W key, you know? Because there are also aspects of, like, I don't know, like managing your points, and which is a thing that's not really thought of in competitive. Like even pro players like don't even think about it sometimes. You need to really, I guess, even out your points, because there are those certain times that we've all been through where you're in the last, I don't know, hour of a cash cup and you have 4 games left and you're like, oh crap, I'm only at what, like 50 points. I have to get to 90 points and to meet my goals. So I need to get what, 40 points in these last games in an hour, and I have 4 games left. So you're like, okay, maybe I should W key this game because I'm a good fighter. Then I should play for placement the last 3 games. Or W key these last 4 games and just hope it works, you know? So yeah. But yeah, guys, that is the video on how to understand a tournament's format properly. If you guys did enjoy, please drop a like and subscribe to the channel. Be sure to check out my Twitch, my Discord, and my Twitter. They are in the description. And yeah, that's really it. So I will see you guys all in the next one. Bye, guys.